Welcome back, everyone. Hardyman here, back for another episode of FTB Beyond Hard Times. And last episode, what did we do? We did the vat back there and the capacitor on the outside. Is it just a capacitor bank or? No, yeah, I think we did the step up from the basic capacitor. So it's like 5 million RF or whatever back there. So you may, I don't know, depends on how this works, but you may be able to hear, if you listen close enough, there's some burning in the background, and I've been cooking up some charcoal and taking it back there to try to get the that bank, try to, you know, get it going. But 5 million, it's a lot. It's a lot of stuff. So I was thinking today we stick with Ender IO and try to go for a combustion engine and use this vat. Because, like I said, I was very interested with this vat, all the things that you can make with it. I looked it up. You can make, the nutrient distillation that we found out. You got hooch, fire water, and something else. I don't remember what it was. But, like, the hooch and the fire water, and I think the other thing, all go into the combustion engine to make it so that it just produces fuel on its own. So I may switch from using coal and charcoal to this combustion engine and I guess, you know, see how well that works. So let's go ahead, get out of F1 and F5 and get to the things. So I guess over here we can start with combustion generator. Pretty simple stuff. I mean, this was what, basically the same as, was it the same as the vat? Basically, instead of the gears, you had two more electrical steel, and instead of the electrical steel at the top, you had a cauldron. So, that, oh, and a piston, I guess, right? Yeah. So, pretty simple stuff. So, let's go ahead and make that. But, if you shift on it, burns liquid fuel, which is the hooch or the fire water or whatever the other thing was, but requires a coolant. And I don't want to just be like, you know, coming back to it, bringing it water so it doesn't explode. So I was thinking, what other options are there? Again, looking through Ender IO, what do we got? Oh, we got this reservoir. So you can add 2 buckets of water for an infinite water source, but that's when connected with other reservoirs. But if you look, if we click on it, the actual recipe gives you 2. So I'm assuming what that means is if we give each of them 2 buckets, or is it just giving one of them 1 bucket each and that is the 2 buckets? I don't know. We'll play around with it. But I guess if we have the 2 that it gives us, it should be enough for an infinite water source, and it should be enough to, I guess, I would assume, provide the water that we would need in the input tank over here, and hopefully enough water for the combustion generator not to explode. But we'll see if I'm right, because I could be wrong. But over here, have the reservoir set up. It's just a cauldron and a whole bunch of fused quartz. If you looked over here, you can also use the hardened glass, the different types of hardened glass, but that required an induction smelter. Don't have that right now. Did have the alloy smelter for the fused quartz glass, so just went back to the nether and got some more of that. So let's go and do that. Let's go see how we set the thing up. Oh, and also, as you can see, pushed everything in one, and maybe this episode we can look into getting a painting machine up. I don't have that into a crafting table since we only had 2s, but maybe. Because I was looking, you need to have conduit facades, which you put into the painting machine with whatever you want to be, whatever you want it painted as. So I assume just cobblestone. We may do that. But anyway, so let's see here. Let's break. Yeah, that's our vat. Interesting. How much do you have left? Not that much. And we're not even at 1 million RF yet. Okay, so I'll probably let this guy do his work, and we'll just figure out where we want to go from there. Because, well, I, whenever I put this in there, I guess I didn't think about that. This guy is actually sending power, I guess, equally to all the machines and to this capacitor bank. I wonder if this capacitor bank is actually going to be able to send stuff out. Let's look inside of him. Yeah, it doesn't have anything like that, so I don't know if it just by default will do that or not. What are the options? Input only, output only, disabled. Okay. Let's just do none for right now, because it looks like it's working. So, let's do that. I may have to set that up whenever we get the combustion generator down, but for now, we're just trying to figure out what we need to do. Oh, well, I guess actually we need probably more of the, fluid guys. What is it? Fluid conduits. So we can actually have that going to and from. And I'm pretty sure, doesn't it just, can I do it with both of them in there? Yes. Okay. So do that, that. So, oh, we're probably gonna need a little bit more then. Cause yeah, I don't know if we can actually pick this thing up and it keep the RF or not. So may get a little bit more of those. So let's see what we needed. I do not remember. Let's see, where are they at? There we go. Quite clear. I do think I made, yeah, I made some more of that. So let's do that. Conduit binder. And we got 8. Thank you very much. Let's do that. Also put on my helmet. I don't want to get blown up. Because there have been a lot of creepers around here whenever I've just been on here by myself. Well, I guess I'm always on here by myself, but away from the camera. Because, yeah, I do not want to die if I can help it. Okay, so we got that. Let's put you down here. Now, I'm thinking maybe we can put these guys in the ground right here. And I guess go fill this up. That. Oh, don't want to pick that, but whatever. Oh, it's actually going into the other tank. Interesting. That's kind of bad for me, because I don't think I can split this bucket. Can I? I don't think I can. Well, jerks. Let's see here. Can I put it beside it and it filled up? No. Well, that's a conundrum. Let's see here. Let's take that out. Okay, now it's just, it gets rid of that water. So I guess we're going to just keep doing this until we get rid of this water. Golly. I did not know it did that, so I probably need to go get another bucket. Oh. Did I hear a guy? Was that me? I don't know. I guess I don't need it to be on 2, right? So, can I get that? There we go. Disable that one. But I guess maybe, well, no, I still need to have the power cable come through. I was thinking maybe if I just put them on top of each other, that way whenever I put a bucket in one, it'll go down to the other one. I can put the next one in, but I still need that power cable to come through here. Oh, zombie's coming. Let's go to sleep real quick. Yeah, I did not know that it would do that. So yeah, I don't know. I may need to make another bucket just so I can 1-2 it in there. Where's he at? Oh, ah, got me. You jerk. Let's go hop in this water. I think we made it just in the nick of time of, you know, getting that off, but whatever. Go, let's get that off there. Okay, don't want to get caught on fire again. Come on. Oh, where's he at? Oh, hey, you guy. Don't trample my crops, please. Oh, got some boots. What are these? Fuel efficiency. I don't even know what that means. Huh. I don't know. I'll have to look that up. It's an interesting enchantment, though. Let's see here. Hopefully... two more? Kylie. Well, I guess... let me break that one. Place it back down. There we go. Finally. Okay. Oh, let's just put that one right there. Didn't mean to get that one. There we go. Let's put that one right there. Ah, golly, you're so fast. You're so fast. Okay, well, then I guess what we can do is extract it. But it's not actually extracting. Hmm. Interesting. There we go. Let's just do that. Get all the water out at once. So, I don't know. Does it have to be powered? It's auto extract. Oh, active when signal. So maybe that was what it was. I don't know. I think maybe... I guess we may need to move this down one. So was it 98? Make sure. Hopefully. Ah, still there. Good, good, good. Okay, so we could do... we can move this stuff down one. Because we'll have the combustion engine right here. And we can have the two tanks... on top of each other right there. Can I get to... nope. Gotta break that block. Get to that to where it is extract only. Don't need that. Blah, blah, blah. So that should be good. Not bread. We need to put water in there. Oh. Okay. It extracted some. Did it put it in here? Did put it in here. It put some in there as well. Huh, do I need more than this two? Or... I do not know. Yeah, because I can't right-click on it. There's no actual, like, inventory, so... hmm. Also, it seems that it may only extract this top one and just leave this bottom one. Because it's not extracting anymore right now. So I'm wondering if it may need to go down. It may be affected like by gravity or whatever. So let's go down. There we go. And I guess take that one away. And that one is extract with no redstone. Ah, so that's what it is. So it is affected by gravity. And are these full now? No. Definitely not that one. Also definitely not that one. But it looks like... it may be trying to go up there? Or I don't know. Because it has blue on these pipes over here. Do not know. We may need to do a couple more then, if that's how it's going to work. Let's see here. I think I have enough quartz for another one. Let's try this out. I don't know if it's working or not, so Let's see here. Well, we need 8. So 16. 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's see. Do I have this? Alloys only. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There we go. So that should be enough for that. Let me go get some more for another reservoir. Go make it over here. Oh, didn't mean to do that, but whatever. I mean, hey, continue the theme, I guess, if that's how you want to be, game. Okay, so put that in there, and that'll give us 2 more, and we'll see if that actually gets us an infinite water source or not. But it is very confusing. I do not, like I've said before, never done anything with this, so just learning as I go. But yeah. See. Let me see if I can put. Or was it just over? It was just over. So. Looks like there's water in there. So I don't know. Do we need like a pump? To pump it up through there? Or not? Because. Whenever it was up here. It was able to, you know, go by, I guess, gravity into this one. But. Maybe it needs some type of power to get it up through there. Let's see here. Fluid respects gravity. Flow rate depending on fluid viscosity. So, yeah, I don't know. Maybe. I guess it would need to be up high. If we're going to do it, then. And it respects gravity. But I do not know. I mean, I guess I can make it, I don't know, maybe build like a little water tower, kind of out here, because, you know, you don't, you could just put maybe that up there, just hanging out, but maybe have like a little semi-themed, water tower. Maybe that would work. I don't know. Because we need to be probably right there-ish in height so that it flows down into this, and well, I guess it would still have to go up to get into that. Or I guess we could take it up off of this and go along this row, and then it would flow down into there but continue to flow through there, possibly. Let's try that. Let's just break all of these pipes. Oh, and that, I guess, too. Why not? Let's see. Let's put these back down. And let's break this. Wait, do I need that? No, let's keep it right now. So we don't need that. Won't need that. We still need that, so let's keep that there. Place that back. And, oh, I guess we'll need to hook this up and that up. Oh yeah, because I moved it over. I was like, why do I have extra energy conduits? But we'll have to go. Oh, I guess I don't need that one if it connects like that. And there. Break that. Let's get this back so it'll actually have power. I mean, I guess I should actually do it just right there. Golly, just make up my mind. There we go. So that should be good. Okay, so we may do a very, very close by water tower looking thing. So let's see. If we're going to do 4. Those, and let's go get the other 2 that are hopefully done cooking. See, there's, oh, 4. Wait, did I count right? I don't think I counted right. I thought they made 2. I guess maybe I thought that for each 1 quartz they made 2, or for every 1 quartz they made 1, therefore 2, but I guess I was mistaken. So two. Is that right? I think so. Maybe. We'll see. I'm quickly running out of quartz. I mean, I guess I can go as much as possible. And any leftover will probably have, you know, enough for some other type of thing in the future. But there's that. So let's see here. What do I want to try to make it look semi-natural and in theme? Let's see. Because I guess I want it to try to connect it over there, but I mean, I guess I could come off of it maybe one. Because let me go ahead and just do the actual piping. Because we're going to go probably along there. And then probably along here. And then one going into the tanks. Give me those back. Thank you. So it would go right there. So we can go ahead and do, guess, just extract without that. So there's that. So exterior wise, I guess, have it surrounded. And it's going to be more on it. There, right there. Do that. May not need that piece. I guess we can just go and do that, and I'll cover that when I hopefully have enough quartz for these next two. Oh, fallen. There we go. Okay, there we go. Should be enough. Oh, I threw them. There they go. There they go. Okay, so that should be enough. It is enough. Throw that in there. Let's go to sleep so we don't lose all the progress that we made with a creeper exploding on us. Oh. Herd feet. Was it you guy? You running around in that house? Are you sure? Any creepers around? Yeah, there's one over there. Just saw him. Let's go take care of him really quickly. Where'd he go? Is he being sneaky? Mr. Creeper, I saw you. You were over here. I guess he despawned. Cause I do not see him. He's not on this side of the hill. There's a spider. Huh. That's weird. Okay. Well, whatever. Let's get back to this. And put these other ones in there. Oh, well, this is also going to be very difficult. Let's see here. What was the actual thing that said about it? When connected with other reservoirs, add 2 buckets of water for an infinite source of water. Produces 1 bucket per second. Right-click with a wrench to enable output or auto output. I wonder how I'm actually going to do that, though, having 2 blocks there, without having them, like, one on top of the other. That is going to be difficult. That's going to be difficult. So let's go ahead, finish off this theme. Let's see, what could we do? Well, I guess we may need actual corners. Because I'm thinking instead of having to just float in here, we have like some legs coming down. But let's go with, I guess, these for right now. May make it a little bit prettier later. But, you know, it's kind of interesting. But yeah, we'll go with that. I guess let me get on top of there. Well, actually, let me make another bucket. So we can actually do multiple at a time, hopefully. I can't guarantee that we will, but... Oh, golly. All right. That was weird. I got both. That's confusing. Anyway, let's go over onto this roof. See how we can do this. I guess also light it up here. Oh, I think I did it. I did it, guys. Sweet. Okay, so we got an infinite source of water, and it's pumping. It is pumping out of there very, very quickly. And it seems to be respecting the flow of gravity like it said it would. And it seems like it has filled both of these. Thank goodness. Okay, so now we just need to figure out how to get the product out of here, which I guess would be the hooch or whatever, into this combustion generator without it connecting there. Which I guess I'm glad I actually did it on this side instead of all the way around here, because then we would be out of side, so. So it's going to try to connect right there. So maybe you'll have to go. I'm probably going to have to get more, actually. So there. There. Oh, well, yeah, we're going to go down and then come up there. Oh, well, yeah. If we come up there, then I won't need that. But we'll go there, down, up. So we're going to need two more. So we're going to need to make, I guess, more of that quite clear, because we only have one. So let's see, we'll need 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I don't remember exactly. All smelting, please. I think it's 3 per quite clear. I'm not exactly certain, but we should see in a moment. But yeah, so it looks like that's working fairly fine. Like I said, I'll need to get that painting machine up, and so we can cover all this up so it doesn't look so hideous from in the inside. So let's do that. Come on. So we got that. So there's that going in. We'll see how much this makes. Hopefully it makes enough for the 3 that we need. Did I already get that? I did. Let's get the binder and go ahead and set it all in there. The rest in there. Okay, so that's enough for more of that, or 8 more of that, whatever. It split on me for whatever reason. Okay, so it's going down, it's going up there. Put it right there. Put it in. And that will be extract only. I guess the, would it be the only in the output tank, right? Oh. Let's take that out of our hand. Because I don't want to do this redstone signal unless it is. Because if it isn't, then we're just going to fill this like entire thing up with water, right? So, I mean, I guess the worst that could happen is I would just need to break them all down again. Okay, good. So it's only going to extract out of the output tank. Good. Golly. Okay, so I think what we could do is I guess try the thing. With, you know, what we have left of the episode. So, let's do, well, I think we have hooch. See this hooch? This is hooch. So, the best thing, I guess we can do some sugar. I think potatoes was one of them. Let's do potato and ice sugar. Let's see if that works. Let's see here. Poisonous potato sugar. Did that work? Oh. Doing something. Let's get some more potatoes. Okay, it is making something. How much of something? Yet to be determined. It's getting close. It is changing colors to like match that hooch down there, so that's going. Is it making its way in there? Oh, wait, I put it too low. Oh, golly. I forgot about that. Yeah, I made it run too low because it would connect. Jerks. I don't know then. If it's not gonna connect up there, if we have enough, we'll just push it in? Or is it just gonna be stuck down there forever? I wonder. Let's see what his next batch. Maybe? It's going in there. Oh! Ah, sweet, it is going. So we do have hooch in there, and it is cooled. Is it? And it is providing RF. Well, golly. Okay, so I guess that other design would have worked, possibly. Well, no, actually, it wouldn't have. Because it was still, the source of it was still below it. So I don't think it would have actually worked, but whatever. We got it working in this sense and fashion, so yeah. We should have power. I guess I'll just have to keep adding sugar or whatever else needs to be in this slot. We have plenty of potatoes, so should be good there. What else do they have? Melon. But it says sugar is probably, I think, the best. Yeah, so I guess I'll have to go harvest some of the sugarcane that we have over there and keep this thing going, but we've gone for a little bit longer than usual. Is that good? Is that bad? Let me know. But hopefully you enjoyed this long episode. If you did, leave a like. If you have any comments, leave those down below. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, you may want to think about doing that. But yeah, got this set up. Contraption. Really made with inner IO, so hopefully it's, you know, pretty good. There's probably, like I've said before, there's probably better ways to do this. But this is the way that I liked it, or I thought about it, so it's special. But yeah, and it kind of works, so can't knock it. Well, you could, but anyway, I'll stop yapping and let you go on with watching other videos. But hopefully you enjoyed. Hope you have a great rest of your day. I'll talk to you next time. Bye-bye.